Hi guys, wish you a very very good morning. This is me Aishu Joshi and you are watching me on the channel of TYS. So here it is 26th of August 2020 and we are going to take today's Hindu news analysis. Okay, so the first news is basically Pulwama attack. It is on Pulwama attack and NIA files charge sheet on Pulwama attack case. Basically, 40 CRPF men were killed by suicide bomber on 14 Feb 2019. Every Indian knows that what happened to us by 14th of Feb by last year. Pulwama attack was a very, very horrible, or I can say a shaking attack for us. So we know very well, more than a year after the Pulwama attack, terror attack, in which 40 CRPF personnel were killed and a car bomb suicide bomber. The NIA, National Investigation Agency, on Tuesday filed a charge sheet and comprising more than 13,000 pages in a Jammu court. The charge sheet said the attack panel planned by Pakistan-based terror group Jaish-e-Mohammed and the Pakistani establishment. We know very well that somewhere that attack was a terrorist attack. The terrorist attack, it means somewhere the terrorist groups are planning something for that. And in these type of investigations and in these type of things, we definitely know that there are few names that is ISI and Jaish-e-Mohammed, and few terrorist groups are there, so that we are damn sure that it can be possible that they are behind all these things. Okay, so the next, what is now happening, the thing happening is Jaish-e-Mohammed is behind all these, is the main planner of all these terrorist activities, and what has happened by Pulwama. And the thing is, the car that blew up the bus ferrying the Jawans on Feb 14th on the Jammu-Srinagar highway was packed with two improvised explosive devices weighing 20 kg, it said. So somewhere Jaish-e-Mohammed is in between all these things, and Jaish-e-Mohammed is the terrorist group which was responsible for that attack. And it was all happened because of all these things, we lost our 40 CRPF personnel. And the charge sheet has been filed against Jaish-e-Mohammed, and the chief of Jaish-e-Mohammed is Masood Azhar, and 18 others are responsible for this. So accordingly, the charge sheet has been filed against all these 19 members. In all, 7 Pakistanis have been indicted, and including Azhar's nephew, that is Umar Farooq, who was killed in an encounter on 29th March in South Kashmir and is said to be the mastermind of the attack. Okay, the next is based on economy. The next article says that economy to shrink in quarter second, and says RBI report. The RBI foresees the economic contraction triggered by the COVID-19 pandemic extending into the second quarter. And especially COVID-19 pandemic extending into the second quarter, especially as the shock to consumption has been severe, and said government consumption would be key to the revival of demand. You know very well that economy is somewhere calculated by the quarter half of the year. And all these things are happening, that because of COVID-19 and pandemic and all, our economy is to shrink in quarter second. That is recently has been going through, and says RBI report. The RBI, basically RBI is accepting the situation that economy is going down, but what we are doing to go through the situation and what we are going to overcome the problems, what we are doing. So all these things are here only, and high frequency indicators that have arrived so far point to a retrenchment in activity that is unprecedented in history. The RBI said it is annual report for 2019-20, which was released on Tuesday. The upticks that become visible in May and June after the lockdown was eased in several parts of the country appeared to have lost strength in July and August. Okay, so somewhere economy is going down, the situation are going worst, but what we are doing to overcome the situation is have to be thinked about and by only RBI and other institutions of finance. Okay, the next case is article is regarding contempt of court. We all know that what is going on from last few days, and Bhushan, the situation of Mr. Bhushan is quite controversial, and what is Prashant Bhushan saying and what is the situation of that, all these things are happening in this particular article. What is wrong in seeking apology? Supreme Court asks Bhushan. Basically, Supreme Court is asking Bhushan that if you are not apologizing, then what is the reason behind this? What is wrong to get apologize? Okay, so the Supreme Court on Tuesday wondered about the consistent resolve shown by the civil rights lawyer Prashant Bhushan is not tendering an apology in the face of contempt, saying you have hurt someone, you must remove the hurt. What is wrong in seeking apology? Is it a sin to apologize? It is said by the Supreme Court, and Mr. Rajiv Dhawan said the institution will collapse if it does not suffer criticism. If it does not suffer extreme criticism, this court can only survive on the basis of strong criticism. Many sitting and retired judges have spoken about the institution in the past. It was to tell the court to look within and reform to seek improvement and advancement of justice. No, it is not necessary to punish him. It is said by Prashant. It is him. Him is for Prashant Bhushan here, and it is said by the Attorney General K.K. Venugopal. So somewhere, if someone is free to say a freedom to speech, if he is getting the freedom to speech, then what is the reason behind this case? What is contempt regarding in this case? Basically, the Prashant Bhushan, who is civil lawyer. Civil judge, he basically he was quite a civil right lawyer. Being a civil right lawyer, he is responsible for the decorum of just judicial services or justice department. Okay, so somewhere the statement he had given regarding the CJI who has posted his picture on a bike, and it was all happening because somewhere he also have the rights to go through all these social media activities, but he is not bounded to get any the situation is going worse. The situation is like he is not ready. Prashant Bhushan, Prashant Bhushan is not ready to get apologized, and the Supreme Court and the other CJI's judges and all the members of judicial services wants him to apologize. So somewhere the situation are not up to the mark, but let's see what is going to be the next, what will the result, and what will be the statement, final statement from Supreme Court regarding this issue. Okay, the next is Parliament session. We know very well that every individual knows that Parliament is having three sessions according to the seasons. Okay, and all these things happens according to the timing and according to the season. So the first thing is, the latest news is that monsoon session from September 14 is going on, and Parliament will have 18 sittings, protective measures in place amid pandemic. The monsoon session of Parliament is likely to be, usually the timing of monsoon session is June to August. Yeah, but now because of pandemic and because of other issues, parliamentary session of monsoon is going on, and it will be started by 14th of September. So this is quite interesting that the session which is for monsoon only, it means for June to August, this is the timing of the session. But because of COVID-19, because of pandemic, the adverse effect of all these things, the parliament is going to be arranged the session, and it will be arranged by 14th of September. Okay, so it is all about it. The monsoon session of parliament is likely to held from September 14 and it will continue till October 1st. Okay, the cabinet committee on parliamentary affairs headed by the defense minister Rajnath Singh has finalized these dates, and there will be 18 sittings, and parliament will meet with a host of protective measures in place to stick to physical distancing and other norms. So it will the first meeting of parliament since the June 15 face-off between the Indian and Chinese troops on LAC, and where it was mentioned that 20 Indian army officials were killed. So after that, the first meeting is going to be held, and let's see what's going to be the next, what will be the surprises that are coming out of this box. And this is the box of budget session of 2020, and let's see monsoon session of 2020. Let's see what is going out and what will the consequences or what will the result of it, and what will be the surprises for us by this particular session. Okay, the next is the article taken from editorial analysis. Okay, editorial session. The first article is Sound and Furry. The Congress leadership seems unwilling to engage in honest introspections. The Sound and Furry at the 7-hour-long virtual meeting of the Congress Working Committee, CWC, on Monday signified a lot. The orchestrated tirade by CWC members against party colleagues was raised, who raised valid concern regarding the functioning of the party, lent credence to a charge the Congress often faces, and that is that it exists for the Gandhi family. And a letter signed by several senior leaders had demanded an active, full-time and visible leadership. Their intent, timing and motivation were questioned by Rahul Gandhi, who continues to influence decision in the party through he resigned as president last year. So basically what is happening in Congress, Rahul Gandhi has already resigned by his post by the last year, and the next step is going, another shaking step is going in Congress party. The leader is going to be changed, the president of Congress party is going to be changed, and what is the next situation or the next step of this party? The situation, actually the meeting was held before 2 days, and it was decided that till the next meeting the leader will not be changed, the leader will be Sonia Gandhi only. But Rahul Gandhi is somewhere disappointed with the party decisions, and he don't want her mother to get down, he don't want her mother to get removed. So all these situations are going on, and the party is quite, you know, burning topic in India. Political situations, according to the situation, political party somewhere is where the all these things are happening. The leader is going to be changed, the president of this party is going to be changed. So somewhere this situation is quite, you know, disturbing, that the party leader is going to be changed, and the leader who is from Gandhi family, who is from ancient honoring family, is now going to replaced with another one. Okay, so let's see what's going to be the next. They have only expressed frustration over his selective interest, and it was Mrs. Gandhi's remarkable accommodative skills and magnanimity that paved the way for the creation of the United Progress Alliance that lasted in government for 2 full terms between 2014 to 2015. Ms. Gandhi's legacy faces a serious threat, not only from her political opponent but also from within the household. If Mr. Gandhi is unwilling to give up his inveteracy and overcome his bitterness towards colleagues. The responsibility falls on Ms. Gandhi to ensure a transparent election, to find a successor along with a new CWC and a parliamentary board. So let's wait for the elections and let's wait for the new leader of Congress at all, okay? But somewhere the point of discussion is only this, that the leader, the honorable person who is the, who have the right to take decisions and who is the whole and soul of a party is now going to be changed. She is basically going to get free by all these things, and the situation of Congress is not up to the mark. That's why Congress is going down. The situation holding according to the public and according to the situation, the position that is holding in present scenario, the position of Congress is quite disturbing, because somewhere Congress is not getting the I can't say, but here, yeah, it is a fact that a Congress is not getting the proper response from public, and they are not giving up to the mark. So somewhere the public is not that much influenced with Congress, and they are going towards the AAP and BJP and all. So government is trying to, so Congress is trying to retake the situation. The Congress is trying to make their own legacy, and in between all these things they want to create their dignity, and dignity should be, and even dignity will be created by only by a step that will be the, you know, it will just a dice to change the leader. The changing leader is just a dice that we are going to throw. We don't know what will be the numbers that are going to come out, but we are going to try it once, okay? The next news is based on UN counterterrorism and down but not out. Basically it is down. Political instability in parts of West Asia and North Africa is allowing the IS space to operate. The UN counterterrorism chief statement to the Security Council on the continuing presence of Islamic State terrorists in West Asia, Africa and elsewhere should be seen as a serious warning by the countries in these regions. 2 years after the Sunni jihadist group was declared defeated, more than 10,000 IS fighters remain active in Iran and Syria, said Vladimir Vorokhon. So IS driven terrorist or terror attacks are on the rise. Besides these two countries where the IS had established a proto state in 2014, destroyed by multilateral war efforts that lasted 4 years, the terror outfit has a province in West Africa with nearly 3,000 fighters, according to the UN. In one war torn Afghanistan, it continues a stage attack and targeting ethnic and religious minority. The IS may no longer control any big city, but its rise from a breakaway faction of Al-Qaeda in Iraq to one of the world's most potent terrorist groups should be a lesson for all stakeholders. Ever since they lost territories. IS fighters withdrew from the front lines and stated operating in cells in the desert, mountaining and hinterlands of conflict-ridden countries. So somewhere we can say that it is going down but not going out. So we still have a huge impact of terrorism on us. We have to be afraid about it. We have to take action regarding this. The UN Security Council have to take actions regarding this, because West Asia, Africa and other related countries are somewhere having a serious warning of it. After the 2 years of jihadist, Sunni jihadist group was declared defeated, they are now much more affected, or I can say much more active in Iran and Syria. So they are going to fight against their insult. Okay. In Syria, Bashar al-Assad government has practically won the civil war, but Syria is now a divided country. While the government controls most of the territories, a coalition of jihadists and rebels is running the Idlib province. In the northeast, the Kurdish rebels have declared autonomy. On the Syrian-Turkish border, Turkey, backed by pro-Turkish rebels, has carved out a buffer and has been in permanent conflict with the Kurds. So somewhere we can say that the situation are not up to the mark, but PM Mustafa al-Kadhimi is torn between US and Iran, pro-Iran Shia militias. They see what is happening. Sunnis are getting aggressive and excited regarding the terrorist activities, but here the Shia are supporting the situation. So somewhere it is not only the issue of religion, or it is not only the issue of terrorism, it is the issue of a group of terrorism which is non-religious or not affected by any other individual group of legal authority. Okay, so they are not afraid of it, they are not aware what is going to be happen and what will the consequences about it, but terrorists always don't have any effect of it, and they don't want to go through all the situation because they are heartless regarding, and the terrorist groups use the religious impact to go through all these activities. So let's see what is going to be the next, and if they fail to address the regional fault lines and continue to fight each other, the jihadists could emerge winners once again. Okay, so let's see what is going to be the next, what will be the impact of all these jihadis and their activities regarding West Asia and other particular situations and countries and areas. Okay. The next is about Kerala. Living with the earth in Kerala, the state's future is inextricably linked to how it converts its natural capital by limiting consumption. Consumption is limited, natural capital, they are literally conserving their natural capital. Natural disasters have by now come to be accepted as a feature of the annual monsoon season in Kerala. In the past 2 years, there has been flooded on an unprecedented scale along with landslides. Last year, 59 people lost their lives in the landslides, and now this year we have seen one at Pettimudi in Idukki district, where a hill collapsed, submerging the houses of estate workers, while they slept. The estimated death tolls had reached 65 some days ago, with prisons still missing. So see, what is the situation? The place which is actually known as the place of heaven, the place of all those people who really cares about the nature, the state is facing a lot of adverse effect all of their love towards nature. The nature is giving them back a very worst situation, and as you know, the nature is trying to make them hurt, or I don't know what the nature wants, but somewhere the people of Kerala is quite disturbed regarding all these what is happening from the last 2 years. Last year there was a landslide again, it is here this year. There was a landslide in Idukki area, and the situation is like 65 plus members has gone and has their lost their life, and still the people are missing. So somewhere we can say that natural conditions, natural management, the disaster management of the state should work promptly, and they have to be alert about all these things, because if you are going to live with earth, then you have to live in Kerala, because the disaster, the natural calamities, the natural beauty, the natural things, and the purity can be there, seen there in the state of Kerala. But now, as what are going on, the natural disasters are happening continuously in Kerala, and the situation is going worse and worse regarding all these natural issues. Okay, so here it is said that what are the what its plunder anywhere, and at the core is politics and past and present. What it is and what it is useful to recall the belief that Kerala was named as or for its geographically. For centuries, its people demonstrated a genius for conserving natural disaster by restraining their consumption. They are just, you know, conserver of nature. They conserve the nature by their love towards nature. This was soon lost as its economy globalized and domestic consumption came to be fueled by wealth generated offshore. Building local infrastructure to support this consumption has become a threat to life. For the state to have a future, consumption has to be limited so that the state's natural capital is not irrevocable. Somewhere in the 1990s, as small telephony was spreading, triumphantly coined the slogan, "Geography is history." We now see what at least some of our history will be shaped by geography. And definitely the disasters make or create the history, and the disasters going on in Kerala are the responsible factors for the Keralian history. And the Keralites are facing a lot towards all these natural disasters, and they are not, you know, aware about the government is trying its best. But here the government have to buckle up themselves, and here it is a fact that natural disaster or natural calamities can't be overtake. Okay, so yeah, we can plan accordingly, we can make the efforts to avoid all these things, but here it is a fact that natural disasters couldn't be avoidable. Okay, so this article is based on Kerala and Kerala's situation. What are the Keralites' situation regarding natural disaster? And they are living with the earth, they are living with the natural beauty, they are living to conserve all these things, and somewhere the nature is taking revenge of it. Okay, and what is the revenge in conservation? I don't know, but nature is not in mood to avoid Kerala at all. And the same thing is happening, the man-made disasters are happening. I don't know, the man-made or nature, no, this is not the man-made basically. All these things what are happening there is just a natural hit, you know, natural disaster. So let's see what is going to be the next and what will the situation, what will be the steps that will be taken by government towards it, and what will be the natural disastrous management natural disaster management will do, what will be the certain area, and what will the people do regarding all these things. Okay, so we have taken almost all the important articles of today. Hope you all got it. If you have any query, any issue, any doubt, anything that you want to share with me, just you can mention in comment section. And special thanks to Ambikesh, who participated in in regular activity, and you wrote very well, Ambikesh. Thanks for being part of Achieve IAS. And also for everyone, just follow our Telegram group, that is Achieve IAS Edu Mandla, and you can also follow our website, that is www.achieveias.co.in, and you can go with us. Thanks for being with me. Bye bye, take care, thanks for watching, keep learning, keep watching. Take care, have a great day.